Hello everyone, thanks for checking out my video. It's Goose coming at you with an update for the Flux Node Halvening. That's right, the halvening is upon us. And what this means is that the collateral requirements for each of the three tiers of Flux Nodes is changing. And they're actually getting lower, so that means more people will be able to get involved with the Flux network. So I'm going to show you in this video how you can restake the new collateral amount, and then start your Flux node. Let's get started. Okay, welcome back. Now, this video assumes that the equipment that you are using is good enough. In other words, that it will meet the minimum benchmarking requirements, which have increased for the new setup. If your equipment does not meet those minimum benchmarking requirements, then you really can't use this video. You would just be wasting your time. What you'll need to do is either rent or build a better server so that it'll meet those minimum benchmarking requirements. Now, with that out of the way, let's take a look at some other info that's really important for this process. The starting block height for the new collateral on a Cumulus tier is 1076532. Now, if you go over to explorer.runonflux.io, you'll see that we're not quite there yet. The top block height is 1076482. So we've got, you know, a little less than 100 blocks to go here. So what I'm going to do is prepare my Zelcore wallet so that I can start the node when the time comes. But keep in mind that whenever you're staking collateral for a Flux node, no matter what tier it is, you need 100 confirmations before you can start your node. So I'm trying to get at this a little bit early so that I'm ready to click start when the time comes. Before we get started with Zelcore, make sure you're running the latest version, which as of right now is 5.13.1, called Vibes. If you don't have this latest version, you can download it from our website, zelcore.io, or log into your account, go to settings, and turn on automatic updates. Then close Zelcore, open it again, and it will automatically download the latest version. And then you would just have to close it down one more time, open it again, and it will be on the latest version. Over in the Zelcore wallet, I'm going to click on my mining wallet and then click on Flux. This is the wallet where I have staked my Flux for the node. And in the top left, it says locked in Flux nodes, 10,000 Flux. But that's the old collateral amount. It's now changing to 1,000 Flux. So what I need to do is unlock this amount right here and then send myself a single transaction for the new amount, which is 1,000 Flux. All right, so let's do that. I'm going to click on back. We're going to go over here to the apps menu, click on Flux nodes. And over here where it says my Flux nodes, we can see that I already have my node here and it says confirmed. So what I'd like to do is remove this so that I can unlock my Flux. And if you click the down arrow, there's a little delete button here. So just click that delete button and then yes, delete Flux node. Okay. Now that has been deleted. We can go back to our wallet. All right, click on Flux. And notice in the top left, it no longer says locked in Flux nodes. There's nothing here, which means I can now spend that amount. I could spend the entire amount if I want. In fact, that's probably what I'm going to do. So I'm going to click on the send button here and then type in my two-factor authentication. And I'm going to choose one of my other wallets here. And I'm just going to click on the maximum amount and then click send. Send. Okay, transaction sent. Now, you may be wondering, why did I send the whole amount? That's because from the other wallet, I'm going to send back the exact amount that I need for my collateral. So let's go do that. And in the other wallet, we have a transaction here for that full amount. It's already been confirmed, so now what I can do is send the exact amount of collateral needed back to my mining address. So I'm going to do that now by clicking send, put in my two-factor authentication, and then up here I'm going to choose my mining address. You could choose whichever wallet you want. I just happen to like using the mining address. And then put in the amount In this case, because it's a Cumulus node, it's 1000. And click on send. Yes, send. Okay, in our transaction history, we can see that 1000 flux was sent out. It has been confirmed, so that means I should be able to go over here to the app menu, click on flux nodes, and it detected we have a Cumulus tier node, but the status is offline, and that's because we need to do some updating on our node itself. And that's going to require us to use PuTTY and log in to the Linux side of it and run the multi-toolbox script so that we can change the collateral transaction ID on the node itself. And that way it'll sync back up to our Zelle Core wallet. So let's go ahead and do that. Okay, once you log into your Flux node, we're going to need to run the multi-toolbox script. And the way to do this, you can go to the guide, which we have. I'll leave a link down in the description. And you're going to want to find, I think it is step 17. Yep, here it is, 17B, Flux node install script. And it's right here. So just copy that text and copy. And then come back over here to here, and then at the command prompt, just right click to paste it, or Control Shift V, and hit enter. And this is the tool that we'll use to reconfigure our node, and we're looking for option number 8, Flux Daemon Reconfiguration. So go ahead and hit number 8, and then enter. And it says fill in all the fields that you want to replace. All right, so in this case, enter your FluxNode identity key generated by Zelle Core. So we're going to go back over to Zelle Core, and I'm going to click the down arrow here, click on Edit, and right here where it says Identity Key, just click that. That'll copy it automatically. All right, and then come back over to the setup screen and paste that there. Go down to OK. And now it's asking for our FluxNode collateral transaction ID. So we'll go back to Zelle Core, click on the collateral transaction ID, go back, and paste that in. OK. All right, now it's asking for our output index. And that output index is a 0. Go ahead and click on 0. All right, it updated all that information. Now it's just restarting the daemon service. In the meantime, I'm going to give a name and IP address to my Flux node in Zelle Core. Okay, I've given it a name. We've got our IP address in there. I can close this up. And let's go back to our script and see how things are going. Looks like that's it. The daemon is restarted. Now, if I want to verify this, I can type in sudo systemctl space status and then zelle-cache.service, and that should give me a list of, you know, a little readout here. And yes, it says it is active and running. Of course, one other way you can check the status of your node is to log into the node's front end. So you just go to your IP address, :16126, and that should pull up this front end. Now, we can go over here to benchmark, and then benchmarks, get status, and that already finished. It looks like we are at the Cumulus status, so everything is good there, and we are waiting to start this node. And back over in the Zelle Core wallet in the Flux Nodes app, I'm just going to check my collateral and how many confirmations. We're at 15, so I got another 85 to go before I can start the node. But once I reach 100, then a little start button will appear, and as long as I'm past that new block height for the new collateral, then I should be able to start the node, and it'll confirm. And it's been a little while, so let's take a look here at my confirmations. Boom, 106, and now I've got my little start button here. So I'm going to go ahead and click that, and then click on Start Flux Node. Okay, it says it successfully started FluxNode. You can leave this window open to track your progress. Already it has changed to started. Or you can click on the Flux OS button, and that will open up a web browser with the front end for your node. And then you can just check the status right here. And already it says Flux has just been started. If you hit the F5 key, that will refresh the page. And we're gonna have to wait anywhere between 1 to 9 or so blocks for this to be confirmed. And when your Flux node is ready, it will say Flux is working correctly. Now we're confirmed and we'll begin earning rewards. And there you have it. This has been how to update your collateral for a Flux node. And this really assumes that the equipment you're using is going to meet those minimum benchmarking requirements. If not, you're really going to need to start from scratch. I'll leave links in the description for how to install a Flux node from scratch. Look into the specs, check out our guides, because our guides make recommendations to different VPS providers that can give you pretty good pricing for a monthly rental on a VPS. Or if you have your own server at home, you want to build something like that, then by all means, it's great to have something like that because it further decentralizes the network. So I hope this has been helpful to you guys. If so, please give us a thumbs up, hit the subscribe button, and we'll see you in the next video. It's the happening. Yeah.